So how do we overcome major disappointments in life? Interesting topic, isn't it? Hey, David Essel here. David Essel's Daily Video Boost, your exclusive online video community. Remember to take notes. Never trust your brain. Take notes right now and share these videos on social media with your email friends, family, etc. Okay? And if you're not receiving these Daily Boost every day, absolutely free, Monday through Friday, go to talkdavid.com right now and sign up for the Daily Boost, and you'll get these videos sent directly to your email early every morning, okay? So how do we overcome disappointment in life? And there's going to be several steps I'm going to give you here, and if you write them down, you're going to have a much better chance of practicing them the next time you hit a major disappointment, or maybe you're going through a disappointment right now and it's going to make a huge difference. So number one is I want you to write down what you're disappointed about. Is it that you've hit a plateau with your weight loss, or you've hit a plateau with finances, or your relationship just doesn't seem to move forward even though you think you're doing things differently? What are you disappointed about? Did you just find out someone betrayed you or cheated on you and there's a massive disappointment going on? So number one is write down what it is that created, what event is creating that feeling of disappointment within. That's number one. Number two is write about what your role was in the disappointment. And I know this is a toughie, but what was it that you've done, or what is it that you haven't done that has led to that loss of the income you were hoping to increase? Or what is it that you've done or haven't done that's created the weight gain again after weight loss? What is it that you've done or haven't done that's created that feeling of a terrible attitude or a low self-esteem or lack of confidence? So number one is to write about what the disappointment in life is. Number two is what was your role? Because we all have a role in creating disappointment in our own existence. It's never just done by someone in the outside world. And then the third step is to reach out and ask for help. Find a counselor, a coach, a minister, a priest, whoever it might be, and ask them to help guide you through the disappointments in life. And the fourth step is a great one. I want you to Google individuals who've overcome huge disappointments in life. You will find so many remarkable come from behind stories of individuals that felt that they were down and out and lost everything, only to create the life they've always wanted. We have examples of people like this in our number one best-selling most recent book, Focus, Slay Your Goals, like Ray Higdon, my friend who overcame this huge financial loss, and he was outrageously disappointed in choices that he had made and things that had gone on. He had taken full control of it. And then all of a sudden in the book, we tell the story how he went from almost bankrupt. He went through foreclosure, single dad, two kids. And through the work that I'm sharing with you right now, he is now currently earning $1 million a month, from absolute near bankruptcy to incredible financial freedom. When we surround ourselves with people that have overcome their own personal disappointments to become super successful in life, it should give us that edge to want to do the same thing. You're never alone. Figure that out by Googling individuals that have overcome great challenges in life. Evelyn Keeling is another one I always talk about, who lost 245 pounds to become a bodybuilder. You see, these are individuals that hit massive disappointments in life, but they slowed down, did the steps I just shared with you right now to rise once again. I want the same for you. If I can help you one-on-one, if I can help you get to that next level, reclaim that self-esteem and self-confidence, email me directly at talkdavid.com. And don't forget to share these videos. They're free. And you can join the Daily Boost once again at talkdavid.com. Have a great day.